About 2 weeks ago, Chloe was diagnosed with cancer. She had a tumor on the back of her tongue, far in the back, that was about the size, the length of your index finger, about the width of her tongue, and very hard. She had trouble eating, and so we made special food for her. We bought her this special soft food. She could no longer eat the hard food. It would fall out of her mouth. She would try desperately to chew it. She'd get some of it, but it'd fall out. Then when she would drink her water, more food that had been stuck in there fell out. And toward the last week, she would drool all over the house, this big, thick, mucusy drool. We kept a stack of towels around just so we could take them and wipe the drool off her mouth, because it was very undignified. Very quickly, her ability to eat deteriorated. Each day, it was harder and harder for her to get the food down her throat. Until toward the end, she really couldn't eat at all. She couldn't stick her tongue out. And in the morning, she'd come to her bowl, she'd stick her muzzle in it, and she wasn't eating. And we knew at that time that we needed to end her suffering. So we took her to the veterinarian close to our home. It's about a mile down the street. And we took her for one last walk. And she was very happy. She had lost a lot of weight. She was skinny, but she was happy to be with us. I went with my wife and my 5-year-old son, and we walked her down the street to the veterinarian's office. This was such a cruel way to go. To be unable to eat, and yet the rest of your body is in relatively good shape. To not use her tongue. One of her favorite pleasures in life, as with any animal, is to eat. And she couldn't do it. And she didn't know what's wrong. She didn't know she had a tumor. She just knew there was some weird reason that her tongue wasn't working. And she got thin and thinner. I got Chloe in 1996. I had purchased a house, my first house. This was before I was married. And I had mentioned to some people that I was thinking about getting a dog. So I was introduced to this young family who had Chloe since she was born, and Chloe was a year old. And I went to visit this family, and I saw the cutest little dog running around the yard playing with the ball. She was so happy. Her name was Chloe, and she was so sweet. And I had been told that she had gone through training. She was housebroken already. She knew her basic commands: sit, stay, lie down. So I took her home with me. The next couple days were very rough, because I had not had a dog in years, since I was a child, and it was a lot to handle. She required a lot of attention as a puppy. She was running around the house, running around the backyard. She would bark in the backyard, and she was being very sweet. It was just a lot for a single guy to handle. She's a big breed, medium breed, but a very muscular, meaty breed. She's half chow and half pit bull. So the second day I had her, I decided that I really wasn't fit to keep her, and I called the previous owners, and I asked if I could bring her back, and they said, they were disappointed, but they said, of course. So I put her on the leash, and I went out to my car, and I opened the door, and I said, come on, let's get in the car, and she wouldn't budge. This is a dog who loves car trips. She loves to just jump in the car and surprise you by sneaking out, and anytime there's a car door open, she's ready to go. She wouldn't get in the car. I tried pulling her, but she wouldn't go. She didn't want to leave. So I realized at that time she had chosen me. She wanted to stay. And that's how I started my relationship with Chloe. And 11 years later, I was forced to do what I think was the humane, right thing to do and put her down. She's been a part of my life for 11 years, and she was so sweet. After she was gone, I asked the rest of my family to leave the room. And I stood there, stroking her head. And I recounted the story of when I first caught her and how she didn't want to leave and how she chose me. I looked at her face and her eyes, they'd rolled up into her head and there was nothing there. She didn't deserve this. It was so unfair to her. It was so unfair. The morning before we took her into the vet, she went out on the patio and sat there, very proud, completely upright, and stared out over the valley below into the fresh air. It was a beautiful sunny day. And she sat there for, seemed like 20 minutes. Then we all came out and joined her, cuddled her, hugged her. It was very emotional, very sad. And then we took her for the one last final walk. We put her on her side and I cradled her in my arms. And I told her that I was so sorry, there was nothing I could do for her. And the doctor injected her in the leg. And within seconds, she was out. I saw her looking at me. I saw her eyes, her sweet eyes looking up at me. And I stroked her ears. And I stroked her face. And then she was gone. And it was so sweet and so sad. And I miss her so much. I think about her all the time. And I smile. And I cry. But I really miss the sound of her. She loved my son. Jingling tags. She kept running around. I miss watching her sleep, not feeling well, or a little blue. She'd come run up next to you and jump on the sofa or the bed or wherever you were and stay there until you felt better. People tell me that she's in heaven now. I miss watching her eat her food. I don't know. That's a nice thought. She was my dog. My dog, Chloe. This is what she wore every day of her life. And that's the sound you would hear when she'd come running in or walking into the room.